Welcome all. Today I am going to discuss a topic from boilers. The topic is boiler draught. This is very interesting, and many students said, sir, there is a lot of confusion in understanding the derivation of boilers, that is boiler draught. So I will try to simplify the derivation, and in this video what I try to do is, what exactly is boiler draught and what is the equation for natural draught, that is we also call it as chimney draught, and how the equation is derived and what are the conditions for that equation. Then we'll go for the maximum mass flow rate, what is the condition. So this is very, very important actually, from like civil services examination, engineering services examination, some local public sector undertakings, and some state level examinations. So this is very, very important topic. So let us discuss boiler draught. Boiler draught, it is also called as draft, boiler draft, no problem at all. Okay, now what exactly is this? Before understanding this, let me put it this way. The generation of steam of any boiler, it depends on, I mean, the rate of generation of steam, it depends on, mostly it depends on how fast the combustion is taking place, and after the combustion, how fast the gases are leaving, and that is replaced by new fresh air, and again the gases are going. So that should move in a faster manner so that more heat is released and faster heat, I mean, the steam is generated. So the generation of steam, to a greater extent depends on, I mean, the rate of generation of steam to a greater extent depends on how fast the air is entering the furnace or grate, and then after combustion, how fast gases are leaving. It depends on that. So therefore, let us try to see in a clear manner what exactly is draught. The difference in pressure created so as to cause the flow of gases, we call it as draught. A simple example is, you just observe, let us take a room. This is our room. Okay, now generally in winter conditions, the outside temperatures are very low. So this is outside. The temperatures are very low, very low. Now, ek kaam karte hai. Now, in the room, generally, we use heaters or we close all the things thereby. So, relatively compared to outside, the temperature in the room in winter is maintained a bit higher. So, let us say this is the temperature of room. This is the outside temperature or ambient temperature. So, I can write the temperature in the room is definitely greater than the ambient temperature. We also know that PV is equal to MRT. I am applying this for air, which can be treated as an ideal gas. I repeat, I am applying this equation for air, which can be treated as an ideal gas. So therefore, this can also be written as P is equal to M by V RT. Okay. So P is equal to, what is M by V? Rho. This is rho. R and T. Okay, no problem at all. This mass by volume is density rho RT. Okay, no problem. I can say at a given pressure, so our pressure is more or less atmospheric, so therefore this is constant. So pressure is constant, so I write rho RT is constant. And you know, rho into T is constant by R. Again, R is constant. This is a new constant. So I can say density into temperature is constant. What does it mean? If the temperature is increasing, the density is decreasing. Wonderful, no problem at all. Now you also know that, so I can say that at this level, as this is at higher temperature, understand carefully, as this is at lower temperature, outside temperatures are low. When the temperature is low, what will be the density? High. So here the density will be high, so I can say outside density is high. Now this is the temperature in the room, the density of air in the room, definitely it will be less. And we know that P is equal to rho gh. So now I can say that at a given height, So H is same. The pressure is dependent on the density. Of course, G is constant. So higher the density, the outside temperature is low, inside temperature is high. So as the outside temperature is low, as the temperature is low, density will be high. So outside density will be high. So definitely, as outside density is high, the outside pressure will be high compared to inside at the same level. So in winter, when you open the door and observe, and if you have not observed, at least next time you observe. So when you open the door, the outside air rushes because the pressure here is more, the pressure here is less. So due to the density difference and the pressure difference is created, due to the density difference, the pressure difference is created, and due to the pressure difference, the air will enter, outside air. So you might have observed this in winter. So this is naturally created. I'm not doing anything. This pressure difference is naturally created due to density difference. That's why this drought, or this we call it as drought, or the pressure difference created. And this is the logic or concept in boiler drought. That is, what pressure difference is created in causing the flow of air and moving these gases out of the chimney. And that is our boiler drought, that we are calculating what is the pressure difference. So larger the pressure difference, easily it can flow. And thereby, when it flows easily, it is substituted by new air, and the combustion will occur faster and the generation of steam will be faster. Now, let us try as to how we obtain the pressure difference and try to understand easily. So yahan tak, I think there should not be any problem. So now what we do is, we'll move to, now a simple diagram bataunga aapko. Let us assume that this is the grate. I'll explain everything, don't worry. Okay, please understand carefully. This ek level le lenge, we'll take one level. I'll explain everything neatly, don't worry. Right. Now, this is the grate. Grate is nothing but a platform on which we have crossed bars so that air flows, and thereby yahan pe combustion ho raha hai. See, combustion is taking place, and after the combustion, the burnt gases are going through this chimney. Let the height of the chimney be capital H. I repeat. So what is capital H? Height of the chimney through which what are flowing. So actually air is entering from outside. There is a fuel in this. There is a furnace. On the grate, fuel is kept, and thereby air, dekho, grate is something like this actually. So we have, it is something like this. Okay, these holes are made so that air can pass through this. So upar fuel lagaya hai. So at the top there is a fuel, and air enters from here, atmosphere, and thereby fuel is there, it burns. After burning, the gases, they move out of this. So this is the flow of gases. This is the flow of gases, and air is entering. This is air. Air is entering. After burning, this is the furnace. After burning, gases are going through this. Now, this H is height of the chimney. So we are actually discussing natural drought. What is natural drought ke liye hum, we'll try to calculate what is H, how much height is required, all those we'll discuss. Now, before that, let us understand carefully. Outside air, let the density of air be rho A. Rho A stands for density of air. I repeat, rho A stands for density of air. Let rho G be density of gases. Let rho G be density of gases. Burnt gases, I repeat, air is coming, there is a fuel. After burning, they transfer heat to water in the boiler. After transferring it, the gases are going out. So let rho G be the density of gases. Let rho A be the density of air. Let the temperature of air be TA. And so I am applying ideal gas equations for air, and therefore what I do is I keep temperatures in strictly in Kelvin. So this TA is the temperature of air in Kelvin. Let TG be the temperature of gases in Kelvin. G stands for burnt gases. A stands for air. Okay, no problem at all. Now observe here. You know, my dear students, yaha pe the gas are going, here the pressure is atmospheric. I write it as PA, PA, and at the same level, this is also atmospheric. Okay, wonderful. Ek kaam karte hai. We'll try to find out. Okay. Now. Okay. We'll try to find out. Dekho, what is the pressure here? Let this be P2. Let the pressure here be P2 in this chimney at the grate level, at the grate level. And let this pressure be P1. Let this pressure be P1 at the same level. Let this pressure be, yahan pe atmospheric ka. So let this, yahan ka, at the same grate level, we are finding out the pressure. We are finding out. P2 is inside this chimney at the grate level and P1 is outside. So this is the one. So and both these are taken at the same height, which is H. But this is the column of air and this is the column of gases. So we know that in fluid mechanics, we have studied pressure at any depth is given by rho GH. But rho GH is a gauge pressure. If you want absolute, add local atmospheric pressure. So agar hame P1 chahiye, if I want P1, what will be P1? So this pressure is PA plus this one. So what is this column? Air, air. So if you want the pressure here, it will be atmospheric. I'm calculating absolute pressure. So it is PA, okay, PA plus rho GH. Ye rho kiska hai? Ye rho kiska hai? Air. Rho A, G, and this height is H. Wonderful, my dear students. Wonderful. Now, please note on that. This is the pressure of air at this level, just outside. Now, let us try to calculate pressure here, P2. And what is P2? Obviously, yaha ka pressure kya hai? Here it is PA. So, PA plus, you are moving down, down. So, you are moving through gases. Therefore, the height is H. Rho G. Rho G H. This rho G stands for density of gases. This is the pressure here, this is the pressure here. Just now I told you, density is inversely proportional to temperature. So here the temperature of gases is high and here the temperature of air is low. As the temperature of air is low, the density of air is high. So definitely ye wala zyada hai. And as the temperature of gases is low, as the temperature of gases is high, so TG is high. After burning, the temperature will be high. Combustion is an exothermic reaction. So therefore, gases ka temperature bahut zyada hota hai. As the temperature is high, here the density will be low. So this rho G is low. If you observe here, GE, GH, GH same hai, PA, PA same hai. But rho A is more, due to lower temperature, density of air is more. As rho A is more, yahan pe the only difference between these two equations is rho A and rho G. That is the only difference. So can I say rho A is greater than rho G? Absolutely, wonderful. So therefore, now I write definitely P1 is greater than P2. And that pressure difference, we call it as boiler drought. It is natural drought because naturally it is created due to the density difference. Now let us calculate the drought, that is difference in pressure. We call it as drought, drought or draft. So what is the difference in pressure? It is P1 minus P2. Wonderful. So what is P1? It is PA plus rho A G H, okay, minus P2. What is P2? P A plus rho G G into H. Okay, so if you want the pressure difference, you just see P A, P A plus minus. Now G H, G H is common, the difference is rho A and rho G. So I will write this as rho A minus rho G into rho A, rho A, rho A minus rho G into GH. And this is the equation for the boiler drought. Now, this H, capital H is chimney height. Already we have seen, my dear students. This capital H is chimney height. Ek bar dekhna. Idhar dekhna. You just see here. Yes, this H is chimney height. Now, this H is chimney height, G is acceleration due to gravity. Now, excellent. Yeah, G is acceleration due to gravity, and rho A is density of air, and rho G is density of gases. Okay, now the next target is to find out density of air, to find out density of gases, then the problem is solved. Now, the next target is rho A and rho G. Let's try to find out rho A and rho G. Chalo. Now, ये इक्वेशन याद रख लेना, बिकॉज आई विल बी यूजिंग दिस इक्वेशन इन माय सबसीक्वेंट एनालिसिस. सो प्लीज डोंट आस्क मी सर वेयर फ्रॉम यू गॉट दिस. ऑलरेडी लेट अस मार्क दिस एज कैपिटल वन. सो फॉर बेटर अंडरस्टैंडिंग लेट अस मार्क इट एज कैपिटल वन. सो द बॉयलर ड्रॉट और द प्रेशर डिफरेंस इज रो ए माइनस रो जी इंटू जी एच. जितना ज्यादा ये डिफरेंस होगा द लार्जर विल बी द व्हाट आई से प्रेशर डिफरेंस, एंड लार्जर इज द प्रेशर डिफरेंस इजी इज द फ्लो, एंड देयर बाय आफ्टर बर्निंग द फ्लो एंड देयर बाय दैट प्लेस इज ऑक्यूपाइड बाय न्यू एयर, अगेन प्रॉपर कंबशन विल टेक प्लेस सो दैट द जनरेशन ऑफ स्टीम विल बी फास्टर. सो दैट्स व्हाई वी कैलकुलेट दिस, because it is indirectly indicating the rate of generation of steam, because steam is generated by taking heat from burned gases. So how fast burned gases after transferring heat they are flowing, that matters a lot. So this part is very very important. So main yaad rakh lunga the Roman number one, this is not normal one, it is Roman number one, is rho A minus rho G into GH. So I'll be using in my subsequent subsequent analysis I'll be using this equation. Ab mera target, now my target is rho A and rho G. Chalo, let's do it. Now, wonderful students, chalo, let's go to rho A. Excellent. We know, my dear students, normal temperature and ab target kya hai? Now, what is the target? The target is to find out rho A and rho G. Okay, we'll do that. Normal temperature and pressure, the normal temperature is 273 Kelvin, that is 0 degree centigrade, and the normal pressure is 101.3 kilopascal or 1.013 bar. Okay, fine. Wonderful. Wonderful, my dear students. Ek kaam karte hai. Look at carefully. Now, you know, let us say there is a gas. Definitely, it is occupying some volume, and let us say it is an ideal gas, take air. You know PV is equal to MRT, so volume kis pe depend ho raha hai? You just see here, PV is MRT, and you know for a given mass this volume is dependent on what? R is anyway constant. This volume is dependent on pressure and temperature. So if I change the pressure on a given mass, volume may change. Similarly, if I change pressure volume, pressure temperature, volume may change. So therefore, now I'll do one thing. Let us calculate the specific volume of air. Now I'm interested in air. First, let me complete the analysis of air, or I would say, let me find out the density of air. Once we complete the analysis, or once we find the density of air, later on we'll move to gases. Okay, fine. Now, let us do all analysis for 1 kg fuel. What does it mean? So you have air fuel ratio, because for combustion you need air. Actually, we need oxygen, but that oxygen is coming from air. So you need air and fuel. So what I do is, let MA be the mass of air for 1 kg fuel. I repeat, my dear friends, all the analysis I am doing on 1 kg fuel. So you may be wondering, sir, we are not using 1 kg fuel. Are baba. For example, if I make an analysis on 1 kg fuel, in actual case, if it is 10, you multiply with 10, that's it. There is nothing wrong. So therefore, now I'll ask you one question. Air is coming, the mass is MA, fuel is coming, and the mass of fuel we have taken it as 1. So here, fuel is taken as 1. Now tell me, after burning, what will be the mass of gases? Mg. So air is coming, fuel is coming. So all the analysis is done on 1 kg. So air plus fuel, gases is Ma plus 1. I repeat, my dear friends. Here Ma stands for mass of air. Of course, all analysis is done for 1 kg fuel. That keep it in mind. So my mass of gases is Ma plus 1 and mass of air is Ma, mass of fuel is 1. Good. Now, ek kaam karte hain. You know, PV is equal to MRT. Okay, no problem. So I want volume by mass. Can we write volume by mass as specific volume? Yes, I can write. So fir se bata raho, now I am interested in air. We'll take care of gases a little later. Now we are finding out the density of air. Why are you finding out the density of air? To find out boiler draught. Because for boiler draught, delta P, rho A, rho G, both are required. Okay. Now specific volume is equal to RT by P. Let us calculate the specific volume under NTP conditions. What do you mean by NTP conditions? Normal temperature and pressure. Let me try to calculate. So this N stands for specific volume at normal temperature and pressure. Iska matlab hai. When I write N here, this temperature is at NTP, that is 273 Kelvin, and this pressure is at NTP, which is 101.3 kilopascal. And whenever I use ideal gas equation, T should be strictly in Kelvin. And one more thing. When R is in kilojoule per kg Kelvin, P should be in kilopascal. I repeat, when R is in kilojoule per kg Kelvin, P should be in kilopascal. Okay, ab dekho, what is R for air? 0.287. And what is the normal temperature? We are calculating at normal temperature. What is this T? 273. By the pressure is, I told, when R is in kilojoule per kg Kelvin, P should be in kilopascal, that is 101.3. So you will get this specific volume. Can you tell me the unit? It is volume by mass, that is meter cube upon kg. Let me try to calculate. I have a calculator, don't worry. Take a second. 0.287 into 273 upon 101.3. This is 0.7734. So it is 0.7734 meter cube per kg. Wonderful, my dear students. Now, wonderful. So this is the specific volume under NTP conditions. Now, ek kaam karte hai. Right. Chalo, this is a specific volume. Let us do one thing. My air is, look at carefully, at a pressure of atmospheric pressure, that is 101.3. The temperature of air is TA. Let the mass of air be MA. Let the volume of air be VA. Wonderful. And let us take NTP conditions. Dekho, NTP conditions. For NTP, what is the pressure? 101.3. What is the temperature? 273 Kelvin. And already you know specific volume is, already we have calculated 0.773 meter cube per kg. No problem at all. Wonderful. You know, my dear students, for a given mass, what I am doing is, for a given mass, I am trying to find out volume of air. So, kya hoga dekho? PV is equal to MRT. So, can I write, please observe carefully, can I write PV by T is equal to MR? Now, we are doing analysis on a given mass. Whatever the mass is there, Ma, it is also Ma, same mass. So mass is same, R is same. So mass is same, R is same. So what I am doing is, for a given mass, if the pressure is changing, what are the changes in volume? For a given mass, if the temperature is changing, what is the change in, see, already every time we do on a given mass. Okay, fine. This is constant. So can I write this as PV by T is equal to constant? Yes. So now let's go here. So ye constant hai. So I'll equate this and I'll equate this. This is at NTP. This is at NTP and these are actual conditions. So therefore PV by T is constant. MR is constant. So PV by T is ka. PV by T is ka. This is at NTP. These are actual. So let us try to do. Very simple. Means you are taking with some reference. difference. And you know, this pressure is 101.3, this also 101.3. So pressure gets cancelled out. So actual volume of air by actual temperature of air is equal to volume at NTP by temperature at NTP. Wonderful, my dear students. So let us try to calculate actual volume of air by actual temperature of T is TA. But you know, I do not know volume at NTP, but we know that specific volume is equal to volume by mass. If you want volume, mass into specific volume. Which specific volume is known? I know the specific volume at NTP. I know the specific volume at NTP. So therefore, volume at NTP is equal to mass of air is constant. Whether it is this mass or this mass, we are doing on a same mass. If masses are different, then the analysis will be absolutely wrong. So therefore, whether it is this mass, it is same. So volume at NTP is mass at NTP. But mass at NTP of air and actually same. So A mass, same to mass of air. And this will be specific volume N. Wonderful, my dear students. So yaha put karna. So VA by TA is equal to VN by TN. What is VN? MA into VN. What is VN? 0.773. Wonderful, my dear students. VN. VA by TA, VA by TA, VN. What is VN? MA into VN. MA, already VN we have calculated. MA into VN, that is the one. And temperature at NTP. So what is the temperature at NTP? It is 273. Now observe here. You may be wondering, kya kar raha hai sir aap? I am interested in density of air. What is density of air? Mass of air by volume of air. So MA by VA is equal to, MA by VA is equal to, I want MA by VA. You bring VA to this side, you throw it to this side. It is 273 by 0.773 into 1 by TA. I repeat. So MA by VA is equal to 273 by 0.773 by TA. So therefore, what is MA by VA? Mass by volume. It is density of air. Ek step aage aage dekho. I want density of air. I want density of gas. So let me calculate this. So kitna aa raha hai? One second, please. 273 divided by 0.773 and it is 353. This value is 353 by TA, temperature of air, and this should be strictly in Kelvin. Oh my God! Now I found the value of density of air. Now what is the target? What is the target? Density of gases. Let us mark this as Roman number 2. Let us mark it as Roman number 2. Dekho, already I gave you delta P is equal to rho A minus rho G into G capital H. Wonderful, my dear students. So H is height of the chimney and rho A is already known to me, 353 by TA. Next, I need to find out rho G. Ab ye yaad rakh lena. Rho A is 353 by TA. That is number 2 equation. Now let's try to find out the target. Next is rho G. The target next is rho G. We'll find out rho G. Now, dekho ek bar. Very good, sirs. Very good. Yahan tak, I think there should not be any problem. Let's try to find out rho g. That is density of gas. Once that is known, the problem is solved. Chalo, koi baat nahi. Look at. Now we'll find out the density of gas. Lekin before that, I'll make some analysis. Most of the fuels, they contain carbon and hydrogen. Most of the fuels are hydrocarbons. So in fact, the carbon percentage is about 80-85% and hydrogen is 10-15%. So hydrogen is relatively less, carbon is very high. Ek bar dekho, carbon, and for this carbon is coming from where? This carbon is coming from where? It is coming from, I repeat, it is coming from fuel. Oxygen. This oxygen is coming from air, means indirectly it is fuel and it is air. It is fuel, it is air. This oxygen is coming from air and this is CO2. What does it mean? Now I write, one volume of carbon requires one volume of oxygen to produce one volume of carbon dioxide. And my dear students, nitrogen doesn't participate in reaction. It is inert. So leave it. Nitrogen is inert. It is not participating in reaction. So leave it. So therefore, I am focusing on, when I say air actually combustion mein, in combustion, when I say air, it is oxygen. I am not saying nitrogen is not there. No, it is in it. Jaise aata hai, waise nikal jata hai. So therefore, now I am focusing on oxygen because it is oxygen that is used in combustion of the fuel. So can I say one volume of oxygen produces one volume of carbon dioxide? Yes. And similarly, you know, hydrogen content is very less. Hydrogen content is very less. So leave it. You can neglect. So iska matlab kya hai? It is indirectly representing what? This oxygen is indirectly representing what? Air. This oxygen is indirectly representing what? Air. And what is this representing? That is gases, products of combustion gases. So one volume. So I can, this is actually a simplified assumption. This is actually the assumption which simplifies our analysis. So it may not lead to accurate results, but otherwise it is very difficult to do that. So therefore, what we are doing is we are making a simplified assumption. That is, the assumption is the volume of air can be treated as equal to volume of gases. I repeat, the volume of air, this, where from air is coming? Oxygen. And this is representing air because nitrogen is inert. So this is representing air and this is representing gases. So now I can assume that, it is reasonable to assume also, one volume is producing one volume. One second, please. Kahan gaya? No. Yes. Next second, please. Yes. Now, this is coming, this oxygen is coming from air. This oxygen is coming from air and this is coming from gases. So I can say, now I can say one volume of oxygen or air is producing one volume of carbon dioxide or gases. So I can say now volume of air is equal to volume of gases. That is the assumption I am making. So reasonable to make, because oxygen matlab air, carbon dioxide means gases predominantly, because hydrogen content is very less. So therefore jo dominate kar raha hai usi ko le rahe hum. So therefore now I can write volume of air is equal to volume of gases. Volume of gases. Ye bahut important hai. Lekin, please understand carefully. When you write this, see, I'll tell you very simple thing. You take one volume. Let us say this is the volume. It is the temperature T. Now, I'll increase the temperature. What would happen? So the gas may expand, the volume may change. So whenever I say, please understand carefully, whenever I say volume of air is equal to volume of gases, means it is at the temperature of air, the volume of gases and volume of air, both under the same conditions, same pressure, same temperature, pay volume same. That is the meaning here. See, obviously, when I take a system and heat, so if temperatures are different, volumes will change. So that will not give you a correct analysis. Here the analysis is, volume of air is equal to volume of gases ka matlab hai at the temperature of air, at the normal temperature of TA. So I will write TA. So at the temperature TA and same pressure, otherwise agar aap pressure change kar rahe hai to volume change ho raha. So there is no logic in that. Means at the same temperature and pressure, sorry, at the same temperature and pressure, I say volumes are same. So therefore, now I write volume of air and volume of gases, these two are same at this temperature. That is the meaning here. That is the meaning. Lekin, our gases are not at TA, they are at TG. Means we have to convert this volume into that TG. Arre, fir se bata raha suno. Volume of air is equal to volume of gases. But this is at these conditions. No. But actual gases are at what temperature? TG. Actual gases are at TG. So I told you, dekho, TV is equal to MRT. My mass is constant, R is constant, and we are calculating at the same pressure. So therefore, V is directly proportional to T. Means V by T is constant. Iska matlab kya hai? I will write this volume of air this volume of air by temperature of air is equal to, please note on that, we are converting this volume in terms of gases. Gases are at what temperature? Tg. So therefore, Vg by Tg, that is the meaning here. Vg by Tg. Please understand this carefully. The assumption here is volume of air is equal to volume of gases. So, matlab kya hai? They are at this, but I should take these gases to that temperature, because jab temperature change ho raha hai, let us say this is Vg dash. Ab dekho, volumes are same ka matlab kya hai? Please understand carefully. When I am changing the pressure, the volume is changing. When I am changing the temperature, volume is changing. So therefore, I should equalize. I should bring it to some reference state. Therefore, this is the equation. This is the equation. But what assumption have you made? The assumption that is made is volume of air is equal to volume of gases. So therefore, I am writing this equation, which is very, very important. So yeah, assumption is very reasonable assumption. This is very reasonable assumption. Now let us proceed. Phir se bata raha suno. The gases are at a temperature Tg, and you said volume of air is equal to volume of gases, but please note down that gases are at Tg, air is at Ta. So that Vg and this V are not same. I didn't mean that. When both are brought to same conditions, this is the equation which is bringing both to same conditions. That's why I have equated. When you are changing the temperature, volume will change differently. So therefore, be careful, my dear students. So now I'll take this equation, Va by Ta is equal to Vg by Tg, and we'll move to the next slide. I repeat, Va by Ta is equal to Vg by Tg. Wonderful. Now, ek second idhar dekhna. While calculating, somewhere we did this. Ek second, I'll show you. We got Va by Ta some value. Dekho, Va by Ta some value. That is Ma into 0.773 by 273. Already we got this value. Now I will use that value. But just now I said Va by Ta is equal to Vg by Tg. Va by Ta is equal to Vg by Tg. So therefore, this Va by Ta already we have calculated. I'll use it there. So M in this value, Ma into 0.773 by 273. Ma into 0.773. Dekho, this Va by Ta is Ma into 0.773 by 273. Wonderful, my dear students. No problem at all. So now can I write volume RER? This value already we have calculated previously. So all when we said volume of air is volume of gases, isko hum already you calculated this value. Oh, value yahan pe substitute karo, already we calculated. Now I am using this. Now you tell me, what is volume of gases? It is Ma into 0.773 Tg by 273. So I got the volume of gases. Now what is density of gases? Density of gases is equal to mass of gases by volume of gases. Just now I gave you mass of air is Ma, fuel is 1, and what is the mass of gases? Air plus fuel, this is fuel, which is 1. For 1 kg you are calculating, Ma is entering, fuel is entering, so gases is Ma plus 1. So therefore, mass of gases is Ma plus 1 by volume of gases. Just now you have calculated volume of gases, yahan put karna. Therefore, density of gas is equal to mass of gases, that is Mg. What is Mg? Ma plus 1 by volume of gases. What is volume of gases? Ma into 0.773 Tg by 273. I have just substituted the volume of gas here, mass of gas. So therefore, density of gas is equal to, let us take this to the top. So this will be Ma plus 1 by Ma. Ma plus 1 by Ma, ye 273 ko upar le jana, 273 by 0.773 Tg. So therefore, rho g will be equal to Ma plus 1 by Ma. Wonderful. And what is 273? Just now we calculated this value. If you calculate, we are getting it as 353 by Tg. So now this is the density of gases. Let us mark this as equation number 3. Wonderful, my dear students. Now, I know density of air. I know density of gases. Now, what is dot? Delta P, Roman number one equation, rho A minus rho G into GH. So, let's do this. Let's try to find out. So, therefore, now let us try to put it. Dekho ek bar. So, ye ho gaya. The boiler dot is given by rho A minus rho G into GH. Wonderful, my dear students. So, the boiler dot is given by rho A, equation number 2. That is 353 by TA. Rho G. What is rho G? MA plus 1 by MA into 353 by TG. That is rho G. Rho A, rho G into GH. So, delta P is equal to, now, I think we can take 353, 353 common, there is GH here, 353, 353 common GH, so I will write this as 353 GH, okay, 353 bahar GH, 1 by TA minus MA plus 1 by MA into 1 by TG. This is the equation for boiler draught, and this will be in Newton per meter square. Why Newton per meter square? Because the pressure is in Newton per meter square. We can express this pressure difference either in terms of water column or in terms of gas column. Matlab jo gas has flow ho rahe, the array, yaar, you know, in fluid mechanics we have studied, the pressure is given by rho gh. So this h can be written as p by rho g. So if I divide this pressure with rho g, I'll get the corresponding height. If I divide with rho g of water, so I'll get height in terms of water. If I divide rho g of gases, I'll get height in terms of gases. So let us try to find out the boiler draught, both in terms of water column and gas column. But this is the fundamental equation. Yaad rakh lena. 353 GH 1 by TA minus MA plus 1 by MA into 1 by TG. So many Newton per meter square. Okay. Now let's try to find out. In terms of water column. You know, my dear students, delta P is equal to, ab hum likh rahe water ke column mein, rho of water G into H of, what does it mean? Already you got boiler draught, ab usko hum height of water mein convert kar rahe, in terms of height of water, water column mein convert kar rahe. So water column mein kya hoga? Delta P by rho water into G. Okay, so height in terms of water column is delta P, already you know, 353 GH into 1 by TA, okay, minus MA plus 1 by MA into 1 by TG, okay, ye ho gaya aapka delta P. This is our delta P, this is our delta P by delta P by rho of water is 1000 into G. Rho of water is 1000. See, I put boiler draught in Newton per meter square, rho of water into G. So, a second, this G gets cancelled out. So, if you want this, it will be so many meter of water, because the pressure was in Newton per meter square and you divided with rho kg per meter cube, meter per, all in our SI system, all. So, meter length is in meter, mass is in kg, okay, right, time to second mein hai, no problem. Okay, 353 H into 10 ki power minus 3, ye upar jayega, into 1 by TA minus MA plus 1 by MA, 1 by TG. Now, so many meter of water. I write clearly, so many meter of water. Okay, no problem at all. Yahan dekho. Please listen. What does 10 power minus 3 meter of water mean? Can I write 10 power minus 3 as mm of water? Yes, I can write. So if you want in terms of, I repeat, if you want this, the draught, this is the draught in mm of water. Because 10 power minus 3 meter of water is mm. So I will write this as 353 H 1 by TA minus MA plus 1 by MA 1 by TG. Ab dekhna, So 10 power minus 3 meter is mm. This is so many mm of water. I repeat, my dear students, this is actually representing boiler draught. This is representing boiler draught in mm of water. Yaad rakh lena, 353 H 1 by Ta minus m plus 1 ma plus 1 by ma 1 by tg, and these temperatures are strictly in Kelvin. So many mm of water. This is the boiler draught in mm of water. This is boiler draught or draft in mm of water. Now let us try to find out draught in gas column. Chalo ek kaam karte hai. So before that, please ek second. Let's try to remember the equation. Bahut important hai. And ye wala bahut important hai. This is the one I'm talking about. This. So ye leke hum try karenge in terms of gas column. Ek second. Now we'll try to convert this in terms of gas column. Okay. Dekho, this is the pressure in Newton per meter square. You know that P is rho gh. Agar aapko draught chahiye gas column mein, to I write this as, if you want in draught column, it will be rho of gases g into गैस कॉलम. तो अगर वाटर में चाहिए तो रो वाटर एच वाटर. इफ यू वांट इन गैसेस रो जी, ये होगा वंडरफुल. सो आई वांट इन टर्म्स ऑफ गैस कॉलम. सो व्हाट विल बी द इक्वेशन? डेल्टा पी बाय रो गैस इनटू जी. डेल्टा पी इज नोन ऑलरेडी. वी हैव फाउंड रो ऑफ गैसेस. आई डोंट नो वेदर यू रिमेंबर और नॉट. एक बार चेक करते हैं समवेयर. यस, इधर देखना. रो ऑफ गैसेस Ma plus 1 by Ma, 353 by Tg. Ma plus 1 by Ma, 353 by Tg. This is the density of gases. Ma plus 1 by Ma, 353 by Tg. Now, where is that? Ye ho gaya aapka. Ab yahan put karunga. Dekho ek bar. So already you know delta P. I'll put delta P here. So Ma plus 1 by Ma, 353 by Tg. Let me check. Ma plus 1 by Ma, 353 by Tg. Okay. So all ab yahan put karenge. Isko hum kya karenge? I'll divide this. Dekho, delta P is known. Ek second. Isko thoda erase karenge. We'll erase this. ये भी प्लेस यूज करेंगे. मीटर ऑफ वाटर आ गया ना. अब यू अंडरस्टूड दिस. सो लेट मी यूटिलाइज दिस प्लेस प्रॉपरली. इन टर्म्स ऑफ गैस कॉलम डेल्टा पी. व्हाट इज डेल्टा पी? 353 g इनटू h 1 बाय टी ए माइनस एम ए प्लस 1 बाय एम ए इनटू 1 बाय टी जी. That is ye wala delta p by rho of gases. What is rho of gases? Just now I told you ma plus 1 by ma into 353 by tg. Already I know this. Okay, so ab hum kya karenge? Isko thoda simplify karenge. We'll simplify this. Okay, sir, no problem. So height in terms of, already this is Newton per meter square and this is density is kg per meter cube. So you will get this in meter of gas column. Array, last time also we got meter of water, but 10 power minus 3 meter of water tha. So that 10 power minus 3 meter of water ko I converted in mm. Actually you get it in meter. Later on I converted. Chalo, idhar dekhenge. Now hg. So ek second please. We'll take this. A place use karenge because there is a lot of place here. Now, so height in terms of gas column is given by, I think we can cancel out 353 aur kuch jayega by, dekho, rho g. This is rho g. Rho g, this is density of gases into, there is g. I repeat, this is the, hg, height in terms of gas column is delta p. This is delta p by rho of gases is ma plus 1 by ma into 353 by tg. This is rho g into, there is g. So ye g cancel ho jayega. So we are left with, in terms of gas column, this will go to the top. So ma tg, these two will go to the top by ma plus 1 into, ye upar jayega, into there is h. So h bahar likhenge. 1 by ta, there is h, I'll write later, minus MA plus 1 by MA into 1 by TG. There is H also. Wonderful. So, isko thoda, but what will be the unit? Meter of gas column. Okay, so HG will be equal to, we'll take it inside. So it will be MA by MA plus 1 into TG by TA, okay, minus, ye andar lena, MA plus 1 jaye, cancel ho jayega, MA, MA gone, okay, I think you are getting 1 into, there is H. Let me check. MA plus 1 is cancelled. You take it inside. MA TG by TA, TG by TA, MA by MA plus 1, ye MA TG denominator mein hai. MA plus 1, I think you are getting 1. So this is the draught in terms of meter of gases. We have calculated draught in mm of water. Ek second dekhna. Please observe here. Wonderful students now. Ek second dekhna. We have calculated draught in mm of water. We have calculated draught in meter of gases. So I'll take these values because I have to use it later. So main ek baar likh lunga. In terms of gases, it is 353 H 1 by TA. I'll be using little later. MA plus 1 by MA 1 by TG. Okay, now this is in terms of mm of water. Let me check, 353 H, 1 by TA, MA plus 1. Okay, aur ye kya hai? In terms of gas columns, it is MA by MA plus 1, TG by TA minus 1. Of course, into H. Into H, this is in terms of gas column. Wonderful, my dear friends. So you can express draught either in terms of mm of water or in terms of meter of gas column. Dekho yahan pe, you may be wondering, sir, why it is meter, why it is mm? Yahan pe 10 power minus 3 meter aya tha. Yahan pe there is nothing like 10 power minus 3 because density of water denominator mein kya tha? 1000. So when it moved to the numerator, 10 power minus 3. That is the difference you should observe. Ab hum kya karenge? Up to this, it is crystal clear. We have calculated delta P, boiler draught, that is Newton per meter square. And later on, we converted that in mm of gases, mm of water and meter of gas column. Wonderful. Now what we do is, let us try to find out the condition for maximum mass flow rate through chimney. Let us find out condition for maximum mass flow rate. Wonderful, my dear friends. Let's try to find out the condition for maximum mass flow rate. Take a second. Maximum mass flow rate. Okay, no problem at all. We know that mass flow rate of gases. Take a second, please. इसको इरेज करेंगे रे बाबा, इसको इरेज करेंगे रे बाबा. हाँ, let's try to find out mass of gases. देखो, mass is equal to rho a v. किसका mass चाहिए? You tell me. किसका mass चाहिए? And you want, please observe here. You want mass flow rate of gases. मतलब gases are going through chimney. Gases are flowing through chimney. Before that, just now you calculated height in terms of gas column. Abhi to kiye the. It was something like H into, already we have done this, MA by MA plus 1, already we have derived this equation, TG by TA minus 1. So many meter of water, sorry, gases. This is in terms of gas column we have calculated. Meter, so many meter. Ab dekho. We know that what is the velocity head? V of gases square by 2g. This is the velocity head. So this height, that is the pressure difference, can, if we want to convert in terms of velocity head, velocity head. So, but please note on that, agar ye gases mein hai, to this head should also be in gases. So therefore, velocity of gases by 2g will give me head, but that will be in terms of gases. That will be in terms of, understand carefully, this will be in terms of gases, this will be. Agar ye gas, don't eat equate velocity of gases by 2g as h of water column? No. So yahan pe gases are flowing, so gas ka velocity, this is the head. I can write also in terms of velocity, this is velocity head in terms of gas column. Already gas column height is calculated, so I have equated both. So if you want the velocity, I will write it as under, are yaar simply hum heads are equivalent head column velocity mein find out kar rahe yaar. So I repeat, you have calculated the head height in terms of gas column, I am converting that into velocity head. Velocity head. So what is velocity head? V square by 2g. So velocity of gas is 2g into hg. Therefore, now velocity of gases is given by under root of 2g into, matlab gases jo grade se jo ja rahe chimney mein ja rahe, so and when they are moving, so this is the velocity of gases, 2g into hg. What is hg? You hg ka value, ye jo hg hai na, you substitute this value, so hg 2g hg. So please, gas ye velocity of gases hai to gas column hi substitute karna, that is h into ma by ma plus 1 into Pg by Pa minus 1. No problem at all. This is the velocity of gases. Now I want mass flow rate. So kiska mass flow rate chahiye? Gases ka. Matlab kitna mass gas ka chimney se nikal ke ja raha hai. So it is rho g and area. Area with which the gases are flowing and velocity of gases. So therefore, mass flow rate is given by dekho gases. And please understand, my dear students, abhi to bataya tha main, density is inversely proportional to temperature. Yes or no? I taught you density is inversely proportional to temperature. I have told you very clearly. So can I write this as density of gas is inversely proportional to temperature of gas? So if I am converting proportion to inequality, I have to introduce a constant. So mass of gases is equal to rho of gases. What is rho of gases? Idhar dekhna. What is rho of gases? Some constant by Tg. Some constant by Tg into area. Dekho, this is density of gases. This is because density is inversely proportional to temperature. I convert proportional to inequality. I got this. So density, mass of gases, density of gases, C by Tg, density into area into Vg. Already Vg is known. That is 2gh ma by ma plus 1 into Tg by Ta minus 1. This is the equation. So this, now I want the condition for maximum mass flow rate. So whenever you want something maximum or minimum, you differentiate with variable and equate it to 0. You differentiate with variable and equate it to 0. Let us check. This is the mass flow rate. You know, my dear students, isko ek will arrange. C is constant, A is constant, and root 2g, height of the chimney is also constant. Ye root 2g bahar liya. Let me take Tg inside. Ye bahar hai. Root mein lenge to Tg square hoga. Ye bahar hai. If I take inside, it will be Tg square. So therefore, root of Ma by Ma plus 1 into Tg by Ta. Let me take ye wala, dekho, I am taking Tg square inside, to kya hoga Tg square, to yahan pe Tg square aayega aur minus, ek second, we'll take pen. Are yaar, what is this, root of 2gh, okay, into ma, okay, 2gh bar ka ma by ma plus 1, ma by ma plus 1, tg by, I have taken this tg inside, so tg tg square minus 1 by, I take tg inside, so it is tg square. Now my dear students, the variable is what? Look at, my air is entering at a constant atmospheric temperature and my mass of air which is coming is fixed. So therefore, the only variable is what? Tg, Tg. So I'm differentiating. So I'm finding out the condition for maximum mass flow rate through the chimney. So therefore, my air mass is constant, this road say air RI, my atmospheric temperature is constant and gas temperature is variable. So I am differentiating with this. So you know very well, common sense is, just dekhna, I want this maximum, ye constant hai, ye maximum chahiye. Agar ye maximum chahiye, to what should be this value? Ye root, are yaar, for example, I want, for example, there is some parameter m. If it is root 6, definitely its value is something. So if it is root 8, anyone, if this value is more, जो रूट के अंदर का वैल्यू है, इफ दैट इज मोर दिस विल बी मोर, मींस इनडायरेक्टली दिस शुड बी, जो रूट के अंदर का है इट शुड बी मैक्सिमम. सो डिफरेंशिएट दिस विद रेस्पेक्ट टू टी जी एंड इक्वेट इट टू जीरो व्हेनेवर यू वांट मैक्सिमम और मिनिमम. आई रिपीट माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, सो इफ यू वांट दिस वैल्यू टू बी मैक्सिमम, सो दिस शुड बी मैक्सिमम डेफिनेटली. देखो 6 से 8 ज्यादा है तो ये ज्यादा है, सो देयरफॉर ओके. Now, look at, so this should be maximum. So you differentiate this with respect to this and equate it to zero. So for maximum mass flow rate of gases, you differentiate with respect to Tg and equate it to zero. Karenge. So Ma by Ma plus 1 to constant hai. देखो Ma by Ma plus 1 कांस्टेंट है, एक सेकंड रुको, एंड ये Tg गया, तो देर इज 1 by Ta, नाउ यू हैव टू, देर इज 1 by Ta, 1 by Tg also, 1 by Tg को डिफरेंशिएट करो, 1 by Tg को डिफरेंशिएट करो तो क्या होगा, इफ आई डिफरेंशिएट 1 by Tg, दैट इज Tg पावर माइनस 1, सो n into x पावर n माइनस 1, माइनस 1 into Tg पावर माइनस 1 माइनस 2, सो इट विल बी माइनस 1 by Tg square. I repeat my dear friends, minus 1 by are 1 by Tg ka matlab kya hai, minus 1 by Tg square, minus, there is minus Tg power minus 2. What is the differentiation of Tg power minus 2? N into x power n minus 1, so minus 2 by Tg cube, so therefore it is minus 2 by Tg cube, and that should be equal to 0. That should be equal to 0. Ab dekho. So therefore, I write Ma by Ma plus 1, 1 by Ta. Ye kya hai? Yahan pe kya hai? Ek bar move karenge isko. 1 by, okay. 1 by Ta, minus है ये, तो एक काम करते हैं, minus of minus, ये plus होगा, ये plus होगा, ये minus है, if I take it to this side, so this plus is equal to this plus, ये minus है, you take it to the right hand side, so it will be plus, already minus minus plus होगा, so I will equate this to this, that's it, Ma by Ma plus 1, 1 by Ta, Tg square is equal to 2 by Tg cube, so Tg square is gone, so you are left with, my dear students, agar aapko Tg chahiye, if you want Tg, it will be 2 times, if you want Tg, it will be 2 Ma plus 1 by Ma, if you want Tg, if you want Tg, 2 Ma plus 1 by Ma by 1 by Ta, kaha hai? 2 Ma plus 1 into Ta, and this is the condition for maximum mass flow rate. If I put this condition there, I'll get maximum mass flow rate. This is very, very important. So for maximum mass flow rate, I repeat, for maximum mass flow rate, the gas temperature should follow this equation. Now kya karenge? What we do is, for maximum mass flow rate, let us try to find out drought. Already, ये याद रख लेना, ये भी लिख लूंगा मैं, because I'll be using this a little later. So therefore, it is 2 into Ma plus 1 by Ma into Ta. Okay, this is the temperature of gases. So, अब क्या करेंगे? Already you have, my dear students, एक बार देखना, already हम derive किए थे, the drought in terms of gas column is Ma by Ma, already I derived this equation, Ma by Ma plus 1 into Tg by Ta minus 1 into H. Ye toh already hum derived kiya, this is in terms of gas column. Let me check, Ma by Ma plus 1, Tg by Ta, yes, already I derived. Toh ab kya karenge? Let me put, you have Tg is equal to twice of Ma plus 1 by Ma into Ta. What is this? This is the condition for maximum mass flow rate. So let us try to find out drought in terms of gas column for maximum mass flow rate. Let us try to find out drought in terms of gas column for maximum mass flow rate. So therefore, drought corresponding to, but this is in gas column, drought corresponding to maximum mass flow rate in terms of gas column is, idhar dekha, MATG, ek second, MA ko idhar lana, TG, MATG by MATG by
MA plus 1, okay, MATG by MA plus 1 by TA. तो क्या आएगा यहां पे? If you rearrange this, अरे यार, so MATG by TA is equal to 2. I think you are getting this value as 2. यहां से calculate करो, 2 आ रहा है. तो अगर ये put करेंगे, I think you are getting this value as 2. You are getting this as 2. Minus 1, ये minus 1 into H. This is HG is equal to 2 minus 1, 1 H. What does it mean? ये बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है. Those who are preparing for civil services, engineering services and some local PSUs, this is very important. For maximum mass flow rate, the draught in terms of gas column is equal to height of the chimney, where capital H stands for height of the chimney. For maximum mass flow rate through chimney, the height in the draught in terms of gas column, the draught in terms of gas column is equal to height of the chimney. ये बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट. Let us say to find out draught in water column. Let us try to find out in terms of water column. एक बार देखते हैं. एक बार देखते हैं. देखो, in terms of water column, you have written it as 353 H into 1 by TA minus MA plus 1 by MA into 1 by TG. This is so many mm of water. This I had already derived. ये तो हम already derived कर चुके हैं. This I had already derived. So no problem. Now हम क्या करेंगे? Let us find the way you have found the draught in terms of gas column for maximum mass flow rate. I will try to find the draught in terms of water column for maximum mass flow rate. So what do? I put this condition. वो क्या है? देखो. हाँ. ये क्या है? This is एक सेकंड. This is TA. Okay, देखो, let's try to find out MA plus 1 by MA TG. क्या होगा बोलो? MA plus 1, this is the condition for maximum flow rate. MA plus 1 by MA 2G is, I think it is 1 by 2 TA. Is it correct? 1 by 2 TA. एक बार चेक करो. 2 MA plus 1 TA. Yes, correct. So therefore, now the draught in terms of water column for maximum mass flow rate. If I put maximum flow condition, so I get draught for in terms of water for maximum flow. This is 353 H 1 by TA minus MA plus 1 by MATG. MA plus 1 by MATG is 1 by 2A. So this is 1 by 2A. Unit check karna. MM of water column. So therefore, height of water column is 353 H. तो देखो एक बार, 2 से मल्टीप्लाई करो, 2 minus 1 1 by 2 TA and that will be equal to 1, ये 2 है, ये 176.5, if I am not wrong. 353 by 2 is 176.5 H by TA unit mm of water column. This is giving me the draught in terms of mm of water for maximum discharge. This is giving me draught in gas column for maximum discharge. So these are the things, and I have tried my level best to simplify the derivation, and this is very, very important. And please, even though the video is very long, try to go through each and everything. And if you have any doubts, you can post your doubts in comment section so that I'll try to address at my convenient time. So hope you have understood what exactly draught is, what is the maximum flow rate, what are the conditions for maximum flow rate. So thank you, my dear students, and I'll come up with many more such wonderful videos. I'll try my level best. Thank you. God bless you. Thank you. Bye-bye.